In this video, we're continuing on with the free KutaSoftware worksheet area of regular polygons. Picking up where we left off in number 15, it tells us that we have a quadrilateral. And remember, these are regular polygons, and for a quadrilateral, each angle is 90 degrees. So if this angle is 90 degrees, and this angle is 90 degrees, but it's split in half, we're going to have a 45, 45, 90 triangle. And remember, the ratio for that is 1 to 1 to the square root of 2. 1 and 1 are the legs of the triangle, and the square root of 2 is the hypotenuse. So it tells us that the radius, which in this case is the hypotenuse, is 16 square root of 2. So let's set up a ratio to solve for the apothem. And if we solve for this, then we will be able to know that it's equal to half the side of that quadrilateral, since that is also 1. So we'll have 16 square root of 2 is to the square root of 2, since that side represents the square root of 2, as our apothem, little a, is to 1, since 1 is represented on this leg when the hypotenuse is the square root of 2. And that's because it's a 45, 45, 90 triangle. So let's solve for a. Cross multiplying, we'll get 16 square root of 2 times 1, which is 16 times the square root of 2, and that's equal to the square root of 2 times a. And when we divide by the square root of 2, notice that the square root of 2s will cancel out, so we'll have that 16 is equal to a. So our apothem is 16. So we're finding the area. A equals 1 half of the apothem, which we know is 16, times the perimeter, P. Let's solve for P. We know that the perimeter is equal to 2 times this one, which is also A. So this side, or any side, equals 2A. So since this is quadrilateral, we'll have 4 sides, and we're multiplying that by 2A. And we solved that A was 16. So this is 4 times 2 times 16. 4 times 2 times 16 is equal to 128. So our perimeter P is 128. So A equals 1 half times 16 times 128, and that will give us 1024. So 1024 is our area for number 15. 1024 units squared. And number 16, we have a hexagon. And remember that for a hexagon, if this point represents the center, this angle is 30 degrees, this angle is 60 degrees, and remember the ratio across from 30 is 1, across from 60 is the square root of 3, and across from 90 is 2. That's the ratio of the sides. It tells us that a side is 16 square root of 3 over 3. So this entire side, if we were to extend this out like the sides of a hexagon, this entire side is 16 square root of 3 over 3. So if we were to divide that by 2 or multiply it by 1 half, that would give us the number for the ratio with 1. But first, let's do the perimeter. Since this is a hexagon, the number of sides is 6. So that perimeter equals 6 times the side length, which is 16 square root of 3 over 3. So simplifying the perimeter, 6 times 16 is 96, and 3 goes into that evenly 32 times. So the perimeter is equal to 32 square root of 3. That is our perimeter P. So now we just have to solve for the apothem. And remember, we can figure out what this one is and then set up a ratio. So a side is 16 square root of 3 over 3, so dividing that by 2 or multiplying by 1 half will give us the length of this leg of the triangle. So 16 square root of 3 over 3 times 1 half, or divided by 2 essentially, will equal 16 square root of 3 over 6. 2 goes into 16 and 6 evenly, so we can simplify this to be 8 times the square root of 3 over 3, since 8 times 2 is 16 and 3 times 2 is 6. Now let's set up our ratio. 1 is to 8 times the square root of 3 over 3, this quantity, as the square root of 3 is to A, since A is currently represented by that square root of 3 ratio. So let's solve for A. We'll cross multiply to get that A is equal to 8 square root of 3 over 3 times the square root of 3. However, notice square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is 3. So we'll get 8 times 3 over 3, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. So A is equal to 8. So we have our apothem and we have the perimeter. So area equals 1 half of the apothem, which is 8, times the perimeter, which is 32 times the square root of 3. 1 half of 8 is 4. 4 times 32 is 128, and we're multiplying that by the square root of 3. So A is equal to 128 times the square root of 3, and that's units squared, as the area in the hexagon in number 16. And if you needed to at the beginning, feel free to draw out that entire hexagon so that you can see the full picture. I just drew a portion of that picture. On to our critical thinking questions. In number 17, it says, find the perimeter of a regular hexagon that has an area of 54 times square root of 3 units squared. So remember that a hexagon, the center point is the vertex of that 30 degree angle. So our ratios are 1 square root of 3, 2. 2 is across from 90, square root of 3 is across from 60 degrees, and 1 is across from 30 degrees. So we're supposed to find the perimeter P. We know that the perimeter of a hexagon, P, equals the number of sides of that hexagon, which is 6, times whatever number is represented by 1, times 2. So let's plug in 1 times x, square root of 3 times x, and 2 times x. So I'm multiplying all of these by the same numbers, so the ratio is still the same. So the perimeter P is equal to 6, the number of sides of the hexagon, and this length, since the midpoint distance is x, this length of one side of the hexagon is 2x. So the perimeter P is 6 times the length of that side, which is 2x. So that is equal to 12x. Now there are many ways to go about solving the problem from here. We're going to plug in our perimeter and our apothem, little a, which is represented by the square root of 3 times x. And we're plugging those in for the area, which we know is 54 times the square root of 3 units squared. So that equals 1 half of the apothem, which is x times the square root of 3, or the square root of 3 times x, and we're multiplying that by 12x. So now I'm going to solve for x, then I'm going to take that x and plug it back in for our perimeter. I'll start by combining like terms on the right. So that's going to be combining my x's, since all of these are multiplied together, and I'm going to combine 12, 1 half, and the square root of 3. So I'll have 54 times the square root of 3 equal to 1 half times 12, which is 6 times the square root of 3, which is 6 square root of 3, and we're multiplying that to x times x, which is x squared. Now I'll divide both sides by 6 square root of 3 to get my x by itself. 54 divided by 6 is equal to 9, and the square root of 3 divided by the square root of 3 is 1. So I'll get that 9 is equal to x squared, since 6 square root of 3 cancels out. Then all I have to do is take the square root of both sides to get that 3 is equal to x. So I'm going to take that value of x, 3, and plug it in for the x in the equation for my perimeter. So I'll have that 12 times x is 12 times 3. So the perimeter, 12 times 3 is 36. So the perimeter is 36 units. And lastly, number 18. Can a regular octagon have an area of 10 units squared? And the answer for this is yes. Yes, it would just not have integral length sides. And what we mean by integral length sides is that the sides of the hexagon will not necessarily be whole numbers. But 10 units squared is definitely possible for a regular octagon. If the octagon had an area of 10 units squared, one side length would be 1.44. So yes, indeed, it is possible. Remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. Also, if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.